Okay, attempt another number 300. I don't know if it's my ISP or my modem or what. I ran a speed test, and everything seems to be working fine, so I don't really know what's going on here. Audio sounds good. Okay, I think everything's working. Not sure how long that'll be the case, but we'll see. Alrighty then. Okay, hopefully, I'm just hoping everything goes off without a hitch for the rest of the stream. Like I said, the DLC episode is sort of like an epilogue and kind of connects the first game to the second one in a little bit. And, there's one thing to keep in mind is there's lots of little details throughout this episode that you gotta kind of keep an eye out for. Like, right off the bat, you may notice some familiar people in the background here, but, like I said, we'll see how it goes. Audio and everything okay? Volume-wise? Hey, it's Kenny's truck. And there's Kenny. Alright, at least it's not being randomly changing volume levels like it did last time. And so 400 Days follows the story of five different people in the first 400 days of the zombie outbreak, basically. And I'm going to try to play them in what I think is a proper chronological order. It doesn't really matter, but that's how I like to do it. So here we go. Start with Vince, or, some people call him Evil Glenn because he's got a goatee, but, apparently having a goatee makes you evil. I think Spock established that.
Damn it. I told you. I already told you it wasn't me, man. Man, come on. I told you like 20 times. I don't even know your brother.
Hey, I know that store.
Shit.
I seen this episode of LA Noir.
Oh, fuck.
Minor spoiler, he's actually stuck on that same stretch of highway Lee starts out on, and he's headed to the same prison as well.
Come on, man.
Can't listen to this crap anymore.
2 hours. Think it'll clear up soon?
What am I, the traffic man? Supposed to have been at the pen an hour ago. I'm gonna get written up for this.
Oh, relax. It's not your fault.
What's your problem, man?
What the hell, man?
What?
You know. Cut it out.
Jesus,
it's like
you
being
guys.
On a bus with a pair of 12
You gonna
girls.
Make me?
Yeah.
Hey, Vince! Justin's gonna make me!
It's too
yeah,
hot.
That's a familiar name.
Shit.
Vince! I'm making him hot now!
Settle down, assholes.
He started it.
Hey, man. How about you open a fucking window?
It's a prison bus, asshole. The windows
hey,
don't
Hey, Justin.
Open.
See
right,
that guy
man.
In the beat-up truck?
Ain't right.
I bet he
Shut
lives in that
there.
Truck now. You probably got his whole house. Life savings. Shit. I bet you stole his dog. You steal his dog, man?
I wasn't stealing
I think he's talking
from
about
guys
Kenny
like
too,
that.
Actually.
Anyway, better than stealing his virginity.
Hey, how many times I gotta tell you?
Here we go.
Seriously, I was falsely accused.
Ew.
How old was she? 15?
Damn it, it ain't like that.
You telling me there wasn't a star witness waiting around in your white van? I'm shocked.
You were convicted, Danny. Gotta admit that much.
Oh, come on, Vince. That don't mean I did it.
My lawyer's gonna be hearing
Tell
about
you what,
this.
Guys. I ain't afraid to say it. I'm really
this.
Missing my girlfriend right now.
I'm guessing she's pretty pissed nerve, at you.
Man. It's I worse swear, than that, man. She won't talk to me. Mouth. Haven't heard her voice in months. Really messing with me, like for real.
Just let it go, man.
You should call her up when we get there. You gotta face that shit.
You know, you're right, man. First call I get.
Danny, I know you don't realize this because you're you, but you probably ruined that poor girl's life, you piece of shit.
Big talk from white collar back there. How many lives you wrecked, kid?
Who cares?
Hotter than hell up in here. I'm getting dehydrated. Hey, how about some water back here?
I mean,
who
do you side with? The Wall Street
Shut
thief
up
or
Stan cried your eyes
the literal
I'm telling
rapist?
You again.
Didn't you lose
crap.
Your shit and tell them you didn't know what you were up, doing?
Or I'll set you
I
up.
Lied. Turns out I'm good at that.
You lied on the stand? See, that's the kind of shit I could never do.
Religious?
Nah, man.
Watch a lot of cop shows?
Nope.
What then?
It just ain't right.
It's a tough call.
Why do more time than you need to?
Gotta stay clean, man.
Says the criminal. You wanna know the funny thing? I don't regret any of it. I carried my victims for years.
Yeah, seriously.
I knew what they were getting into. And now here I am, and there they are. And Wall Street assholes pulling the same scores are smiling on TV. Fuck that.
How did it all work, anyway?
It was like a pyramid scheme.
I mean, he ripped off rich
kinda
people. I mean, morally,
shit.
There's a clear
it
difference
It was a really
here.
Good pyramid scheme.
Fuck Wall Street.
Fuck Wall Street.
Fuck Wall Street.
How much
yeah,
did you make off with, anyway?
Enough.
So, like, a couple hundred K?
A little over 100. Million.
God damn, boy.
Oh,
damn, give me some
when we
that.
Get out of here, you, me, and Vince, we gotta go into business, know what I'm saying?
You know, I don't actually know a thing about you, Vince. Maybe he's a priest.
Yeah, Father Vincent.
I bet he touched a kid.
Two kids.
What
you touch
people
a couple
accusing
kids,
being
Vince?
A kid toucher
I helped
in this
my
game.
Little brother.
They send you to prison for that now?
He was in trouble. I had to help him out.
First Lee and now Vince.
I knew it was something stupid.
You regret it, man? If you're saying what I think you are, I got respect for you, man.
I don't regret it at all. Sometimes You gotta do the hard thing.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
That's what she said.
How'd they get you?
Tossed the gun up on a roof.
And?
It was a good throw, and a roofer found it the next day.
You gotta be kidding me. Man, you're bad luck, Vince. Bad luck, Vince! That's not bad. What do you think, Justin?
What the fuck are you gonna do about it?
Fuck you!
Fuck me? Fuck you, motherfucker!
Oh, Jesus man. Christ!
What the hell is going on,
man? Crabtree, knock it off!
Hey, get in there, man!
Hey, let him go, man!
Damn it, Crabtree! Don't make me come back there
now! He's gonna kill him, Vince! Let the guard handle it, guys.
Fuck that! We gotta get in there!
You do not want to get in the middle of that shit, Danny.
Vince, we gotta do something. You know this ain't right.
I'm not doing any more time to save some stupid app.
We can't do anything with these damn chains on. Shit!
Crabtree, I'm warning you one
He's
last time, goddammit!
You gotta get in there!
Get yourself in there and wake that shit
up,
man!
Come on, man!
Come on, boy! Get back there!
Okay, asshole. Let him go!
Get in between them, goddammit! He's gonna kill
this
that
guy really inspires confidence.
Crabtree? Last
what
warning!
You
I said
do
let
something.
Him go, goddammit!
It's not what I meant.
What the fuck
Holy
was
shit,
that?
Fuck.
Jesus. What happened?
What did you do, boy? Goddammit, boy!
Damn.
Answer me back
That guy's
there.
Still alive! Get those cuffs off him, man! What the hell was that?
He made a move on me! I don't know!
He's still breathing?
He's,
Fuck! You gotta call someone, man!
What?
I'm calling this in!
Don't call it in yet! Just wait, okay? Just give me a damn minute!
He might still be alive! Call a damn ambulance, man!
I just need a minute! I need a minute to think!
You ain't got a minute!
Shut up, you hear me? Just shut your mouth!
Okay.
Calm down. There, Barney Fife.
Take it easy.
I'll calm down when you quit running your fucking mouth.
Everybody needs to calm the fuck down. Situation's bad enough as it is.
He's right. Let's all just take it down a notch, okay?
You really want to pull that trigger again, son?
Thanks, man.
What the fuck?
Did you see that?
I saw it.
Yeah.
Hey, you gotta get us the hell out of here.
You're not going anywhere!
Fuck that! Get this bus moving! Hey, driver!
But I said,
let's go,
we're
man!
We're staying right here! We're safe inside the bus! Nothing's gonna
Holy shit!
Jesus! Oh my
Always
god.
Always with the jugular
hey.
Bite.
Hey, you need to call someone. You hear me? We need to. Did he just bail on us?
Oh, Jesus.
These guards suck
ass. What the hell, man?
Back up.
Fuck.
He can't reach us.
You sure about that?
That ankle's gonna give.
Shit. What are we doing, guys?
Come on. We gotta do something.
I'm trying to think.
Better think fast, man.
Find a weapon.
What kind of weapon?
Where's the guard's gun?
Yeah, the gun. Good thinking, Justin. Where the fuck is it?
I think he fell on it. It's underneath it.
Oh, fuck me.
More quick time events.
Get the gun, man.
Pick it up, Vince.
Hurry up. Shoot this asshole, Vince.
Do it.
Watch it, man.
Sorry.
Man, I can't believe this shit. Can you believe this shit, man?
No.
We gotta find some way to get out of here.
We should just wait for help.
The chain runs through that loop that's welded to the floor. No chance of busting that.
Shit.
Pointless.
Where are the damn keys, man?
They weren't on him.
Well,
yeah,
shit,
the
if the keys aren't on him, then where the hell are they?
He must have left them up front.
Maybe we finally caught a break.
Danny,
hey,
don't.
Buddy! What the fuck?
God damn it, Danny. You always put your fucking foot in.
Fuck you, man.
We gotta get out of here before any more of them show up.
That's not gonna hold.
Vince! Fire the fucking gun!
I think he just pissed them off.
Yeah. Yeah, save the shells.
Need those keys.
Take out the windows!
Whoa, whoa, watch it!
Ain't gonna work. How the hell are we gonna get out of here?
There's gotta be a way. Can't we just shoot off the chains?
No way.
I literally just tried that.
What about the cuff? If we shoot one of those off, the chain will slip right out.
Are you fucking insane? What do you think is gonna happen if you fire a shotgun that close to someone's throat?
Well, what do you think's gonna happen if we don't get the fuck out of here? Vince, give me the gun. We gotta do this. Back off. Vince, what the fuck?
Whoa.
Decision time.
Hey, I know you're a good guy.
Sorry, Mr. Rapist, dude.
Fuck you!
I mean, not
do
sorry,
it.
But...
Hurry! Justin's just gonna slow you down.
Do it again!
I mean, he stood up for us, but still, come on.
Come on, let's go!
So, like I said, you know, relatively short stories compared to the main game. Y'all still with me? All right, 1 second. How's that sound? Alrighty then. It's like I said, I don't, you know, I leave the settings as they are, and the audio is so different in between episodes, it's ridiculous. Computers kind of tick me off like that. Okay, time for Wyatt's story.
Why the hell did you shoot that guy, man? What the hell was that?
I didn't mean to do it. It just happened, okay? Where the fuck were you with a warning?
Me? You're putting that on me now? I didn't see the guy either. I was too worried those dudes were gonna pull guns on us.
Shit! Dude, how'd they catch up to us?
Who gives a shit? Just... Hurry up, Eddie!
Here, man. Shoot! Get him, man!
Hold still, Danny.
Holy shit, man, did you get him? Are they back there? Wyatt? Dude, are they there or not? Come on!
I don't see anything.
Are you sure? Those guys wouldn't just give up.
I don't see anything.
Here, I'll turn off.
Yeah, I love these guys, by the way. They're like just a couple of stoners stuck in the zombie apocalypse.
I feel that look on me, man. I'm not being an asshole. I'm being smart. No lights, no, you know, they can't see us. Christ, I can
taste blood in my mouth. I don't think it's mine.
Crashing into a cow ain't gonna help anything,
man. Oh, shit! I should watch out for cows! Cows! Why didn't I think of that? When's the last time you saw a cow, dude?
Okay, bad example, but you could still hit something, man.
God, I can't believe we're in this shit.
Don't barf just yet, okay? Please? This road is really straight. We'll be fine.
At least slow down.
What? Fuck no. Did you see that one guy's eyes, man? He's fucking gorked. I don't want that guy in my life, Wyatt.
Gorked? I should use that.
Dude, you are covered in that guy's blood.
I know, Wyatt. My shirt is soaked. It's like, I just... Why didn't they say anything? Guy's taking his shit over there. That's all they had to say.
I'm sure it was an accident.
I'm not. I wish I was, but... Ow.
Nice.
Look, Wyatt, all I know is those guys had me all jacked up, like I was on speed or something. I was just on edge, you know? Then I was like watching that guy's brains come out of the back of his head. Sorry, man.
You're a little creepy there, dude.
Don't sweat it, man. It's about time.
I will punch your eyes.
Punch my eyes? I need those.
See? It's fine. Road's straight as my dick.
No.
You think we're in the clear?
Don't talk about your dick.
Why not?
Seriously.
All right, let's Tom Cruise out of here.
Please, never talk again.
See if there's still any sticky in the glove box.
See, I love these guys. They're hilarious.
I don't see anything.
Dude, it's in there. Look harder.
I don't see it. What I do see is that ammo that you lost last week.
Oh my god, really? But is there any weed?
Yeah, you just evaded an angry, vengeful murderer, dude. You remember? Might as well get high.
She told me that she was 5, I think. Her dad took her to the circus.
Think loading the gun is probably more important right this second. Thanks.
Okay. Weird, but okay. Shit!
Oh, shit. I was about to agree, and then that just scared the crap out of me.
Holy shit, dude. Holy shit. Did you get a look? I think that was a guy. Wyatt, come on, man. Say something. Was that a dude or not? What the fucking fog? This night is so fucked, man.
It didn't look human, alive, whatever.
Really? Seriously? I mean, seriously? Look me in the eyes and say that.
You heard me, Eddie.
Let's see if there's anything around the car. You know, anything that'll, like, tell us one way or the other. That way we can just book. But I'm not leaving if we hit a human being, man. I'm just not.
My vote is just book it anyway. Screw it. Who cares?
Man, don't roll it down broken.
I can't see through the cracks. Look, it's fine, see?
Dude, what's that on the broken side mirror?
It's part of a shirt, I think.
Yeah, but plenty of dead guys have shirts on. Keep looking.
It's the ones lacking shirts you gotta look out for. They're kind of wild.
Does that blood look fresh to you?
Yeah, but
yeah, if it wasn't before, it is now.
Yeah. Damn.
What's that way out in the road?
Is that the mirror from the car?
Can't tell from here. Man, I'm really not seeing anything. Stop messing around. We need to know what's going on, okay? That's not gonna help.
Okay, okay.
Don't judge me.
Look, Wyatt, it was a guy.
Are you sure?
Yes.
How sure?
Pretty fucking sure. Don't eat a burrito and get on a roller coaster, sure.
Jesus.
I love this guy's sayings.
So what do we do?
What do you mean, what do we do? We go out there. What about the guys in the truck?
Man, fuck those guys! If that guy back there is alive, we have to help him, Wyatt. There ain't a lot of live dudes left these days.
We can't just hang out here all night.
Out and back in, that's all I'm talking about. Come on, man. This is stupid. We go out there, we check it out, we get moving.
Both of us?
I mean, I don't know. Me? I hit the fucking guy. One of us should stay here, though, in case.
And if you got a quick enough eye, you might have actually been able to recognize the person they hit, but...
Okay. Well... Shit, okay. Here, we'll rock, paper, scissors for it.
You have like a split second to see him, though.
Fine.
Okay, cool, good. This is good. We need to hurry up.
Yeah, most games of rock, paper, scissors don't result in you getting your throat ripped out.
I can't believe I'm doing this shit.
Dude, 2 seconds, it's over. Alright, 2 out of 3, right?
Sure.
1, 2, 3, go. Man.
Shit.
Okay. Alright. 1, 2, 3, go. Fuck! What are the chances of that? Okay. 1, 2, 3, go. Ah! Paper never wins, dude. Paper is the Martin Scorsese of hand gestures.
The hell does that mean?
Son of a bitch.
That's interesting, though, because I've never actually lost the rock, paper, scissors game. It's always Eddie that goes out when I've played this.
All right. I got this.
Be careful, dude.
Oh, man, screw every part of this.
Man, it'd be easy as shit to get lost out there.
You gotta hurry up, dude. Thing is jacked. Should I take it? No, man.
Kind of useless now, right? About as useless as the spine of whoever we hit, probably.
Hurry up.
It'd be great, backpack, if you could tell me if your owner was alive or not. All right, I guess I'll just keep talking to myself out here because that makes sense.
I see a lot of fog, buddy. Oh, he's already crawling.
Holy shit, that's a fuck ton of blood.
This is like 10 times creepier, man, like actually being out here. Thanks, Eddie. That's helpful.
Why the hell am I following this thing? Nothing good's at the end of it.
Hey, man! You okay?
Yeah, make lots of noise. Attract all the geeks around you.
Oh, shit.
Are you okay?
It's the driver from the prison bus.
Sir? Can you hear me?
Damn it, man, are you gonna be alright? Fucking help me out!
Dude got pulverized. No, he's not gonna be okay.
Okay,
Oh, this is horrible. I mean, seriously, you gotta just leave the guy. He's not gonna live, and I mean, come on. Dude got flattened. What can I really
do? Sorry, dude.
Come on.
Gotta split.
Other than, you know, maybe put him out of his misery. Oh, I don't like how that sounds at all.
Oh,
Just handing out headshots when he's coming. Just ringing the dinner bell over and over. Oh shit, it's the truck. Try running, dude.
Come on, man. It was just getting started.
Yeah, I'm actually glad I lost the rock, paper, scissors game that time, because that was 1,000 times creepier. Otherwise, you just sit in the vehicle and complain the whole time, and it's until that dude shows up. Okay, so this next one, there's a special little Easter egg the developers left in here, depending on a choice you make, and let's see if you guys can catch it. Time for Russell's story.
Got like 60 miles left, I think. Ain't shit.
Walking 60 miles? Screw that. So hey, does this highway, stretch of highway, look kind of familiar, or...
I should probably hurry.
Uh-oh.
Shit, shit, shit.
Oh, who could that be?
Yuck. Fucking gross, man.
I got reunited with an old friend. Yeah, that's just cruel on the part of Telltale Games, to be honest.
I see you culling with your girlfriend down there.
Shit, bro.
That's gross, kid. Although I ain't gonna judge what you do with any dead body. However you get your kicks, you know?
Ew.
Look, I don't care what you do to whatever corpse you find.
I wasn't...
What's your name?
Russell.
So you didn't steal that bag. I don't care who you steal from, if you did. Maybe you're in a gang that likes to rob people. I don't know. Are you in a
or
crew?
Maybe you are.
You got some boys wearing hoodies I gotta worry about?
It's mine. I didn't steal it.
All right, good. I don't like thieves. Just get in the car. You're gonna get eaten out here otherwise, and I'm bored. Come on.
You got crazy eyes.
Scoot. I ain't gonna wait forever.
You take me to Statesboro? I'm trying to get to my grand's house.
Fuck, she like to party? Just get in. We'll get there.
Dude.
Somewhere. Eventually.
Rugged, reliable Chove truck. It's a great brand.
Name's Nate, by the way. Thanks for asking. You thirsty? Here you go.
Yeah, no kidding. And she probably slipped something in there.
That shit, ain't it? Hell of a kick, but
he's got a deliverance vibe around him. You never know.
You'll get used to it.
Actually, I think that's it for me. I'm good.
All right, fine. You want to tell me about where you come from, at least? Must have been with a crew. Any tail back where you come from? Maybe drop you off, do a double back.
Dude reminds me of Merle from the show.
no tail.
Damn. I retract my question.
There was a girl who I liked, all right.
You're arguing semantics, Russ. Give a pal the deets.
All right. There was seven of us. I didn't have any family there or nothing. They're all at my grand's down in Statesboro. There was a dad who had a daughter about my age. One guy said he used to be a cop, but nobody really believed him. Then a teacher and his wife. Leader was this guy, Steve.
Go back to the daughter.
Steve was a bad dude, but everybody was with him, you know? He said seven was the magic number, so...
What are the dudes named Steve being super shifty?
We found survivors. It was the same every time.
Let it out, Paco.
Just... We gonna kill these folks and take their stuff or what? Then bang! They'd be dead. Anyway, I couldn't handle that. After weeks of it, I packed my shit up and figured I could make for Grands alone and try to find my family. I slipped out of there. I couldn't live like that.
So nobody got down with the daughter then?
No, they didn't.
Dude.
What would you give her? Strong six? Just tell me something about her. How was the rat? Give me a little something.
Just a taste.
Gross.
Russ, I'm doing you a service here. I gotta get my beak wet. I'll put it right in here.
Sure, whatever.
Sure, whatever? Come on. All right, maybe someone who wasn't so near and dear to your heart then.
What the fuck?
Come on. Scale of 1 to 10. What do you think? Slamming before she was rocked, right? What do you think?
Holy shit,
get a look.
Fuck!
Like a 9, right?
Get off me!
Maybe you got high standards.
Help!
If you say 5, I'm gonna flip.
Fuck!
Tell me, Russ.
10, okay? 10, you psycho!
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Damn it. You load that
psychopath.
Bullets in the glove there.
I should shoot him with it, seriously. There's that gas station again. So how'd you guys like Carly's little cameo back there?
Let's look for some supplies in here. See if we can fill up while we're at it. Don't be mad. Fine, be mad. Just stop being a pussy.
Alright.
Oh shit! Go! Get up!
This poor kid can't catch a break.
Russ! Get the fuck down, man! You don't want to be there! Get to the truck! I'll cover you!
You got bullets this time?
Don't think about it. Just run. I'll keep his fucking head down.
Typically, you don't want to hide behind a gas pump when someone shoots. Call me crazy.
Good hustle.
What happened to I'll cover you?
Look how good you did.
All right. What are we going to do?
First, we're going to figure out exactly where this asshole is. Just get a quick glance. Down. See? Easy. Now we know where he is and we can fucking get him.
All right. Yeah.
That's the spirit. Let's push this truck for cover.
Okay.
It's in neutral. Just keep your head down.
I love how his door, as the only moving part on the truck in that scene, was a different color than the
shit!
Truck.
It's like just keep pushing! Shit! Push! End of the road.
What now?
We're gonna get around the side of the building. We gotta go from cover to cover. Seriously, this time. I'm not fucking around.
You gonna cover me?
If we get to that car, we'll be out of the line of fire. Here. You can cover me first. I'm not fucking around. You cover me, then I'll cover you. Or if you wanna go first, that's fine too.
I'll cover you. You go first.
Or I can shoot it in the back.
Shoot at the window and keep that fucker's head down till I get where I'm going. Throw me the gun, and I'll do the same.
Ready?
Yeah.
You ready, Russ? Remember, don't stop shooting. Fire! All right, throw me the gun, and I'll cover you. Go! Good job!
Now what?
We get over there and we should be good. Go!
Screw Nate, man, seriously.
Thanks.
We're not done yet. Let's see if we can get in around back.
Sneak up on this asshole.
Follow me.
Man, what are we doing?
Well, we gotta get in there. Fucker shot at us. Russell, relax, man. When this is over, we're gonna take what we can, head on down to your Grams, and have a big ol' home-cooked meal, all right?
I mean, Nate shoots at other people all the time. It seems kind of hypocritical for him to get pissy about it.
Come on. Watch out for that. What's the problem?
Oh, hey, it's a useless cop from the bus.
Nothing. No problem.
Then come on. Russ, come on.
Damn. Hey, he's got normal eyes instead of those, you know,
okay, it's
foggy
clear.
Walker eyes.
Keep your head down and follow me. You got it. All right. We're gonna be fucking quiet. We're gonna sneak up on this son of a bitch and take him out. You hear me? Not a fucking beep. Let's go.
How did he not hear us already? Listen to all the noise we're making.
I see him. Check through the window. See if there's anyone else.
Whoops.
I think I saw a guy.
No shit.
I thought I saw a chrome dome.
Grab him. I'll cover you.
Do I sneak up? Or just jump out and grab it?
Your call.
You shout, "Oga, oga, oga," and jump over the counter. Maybe throw a chair at him.
Here, you monsters!
Whoa, Gramps!
I told you not to come back here! Think you could just leave your mask at home? And now you're with this fucking spook!
First off, watch the fucking racism. This is my boy. Secondly, I don't fucking know you. We were just passing by like anyone else.
Bullshit! You came back to finish us off and take all our food!
You've lost your goddamn marbles.
She's dying, and now she can see your face.
We've never been here, sir.
Then who shot my wife?
Wasn't us.
You tried to kill us for no goddamn reason. If anything, we should take you out for that.
Please just get the fuck out of here. Please leave us alone.
What do you say, Russ? Should we just kill these folks and take all their stuff?
Dude. Oh yeah, he's got crazy eyes. Look at that.
I'm done. That's it, man. I don't know you, and I don't want to.
Can't you take a fucking joke?
Fuck your jokes. I'm sorry, I'm out.
Come on. Can we still be friends?
No.
Damn. So Nate seems like a fun guy, eh? This comes Bonnie, who is, well, I won't give anything away. Just one more episode after this, or story after this, and then the epilogue.
Okay, I got one. A snake for a tongue.
You're so bad at this.
Would you rather have a snake for a tongue?
Awful.
Or lobster claws for hands?
Are the claws lobster size or human size?
Human size? Can make this easy on you. Well?
I'm thinking.
Think harder.
And how exactly do you think harder?
Good point. I'll think about that.
Lobster claws.
Weirdo.
Think of all the crazy stuff you could grab.
All I'm saying is, good luck finding a man if you have lobster hands.
Good thing I'm not looking for one, then.
You don't know, man. That could be somebody's fetish.
Okay. How about...
Some guys just want to get pinched, you know?
I probably ought to stop bugging you with stupid hypotheticals.
Oh, come on. You'd be a lot less fun.
You've been a lot more fun lately. Feeling better?
I guess I am.
Well, you sure do look better. Though, you gotta admit, anything is an improvement. That came out wrong.
Wow.
What I mean is... You were...
Take a hike, big ears.
I resemble that remark.
You resemble a satellite.
You know, you weren't so damn sassy before. Guess that's a good sign. I mean,
some chemistry here.
After we found you, you were still so hooked on that stuff. Well, I never thought you'd make it. You ain't out of the woods yet, I know, but... Well, you've come a long way, Bonnie.
Oh, wait, I forgot Bonnie's, like, in her 20s, though, I think.
Yeah, she I'm a real poster child.
I can see you on a brochure.
Oh, like the ones at the dentist? Before and after, with the puffy face and the yellow teeth?
Just look at her now. Look, you know I ain't going nowhere, right? As long as we're together, I'll be there for you. You ain't gotta worry. You know that, right?
I know. God, Leland, thank you.
Bonnie,
Leland? Uh-oh. Bonnie?
Dee.
Hey, honey. I found us something. What are you two up to?
Just chatting.
Chatting, huh? What about?
Oh, lobsters.
Lobsters?
Well, fishing. Figured it'd be worth a shot. For the food, you know.
Leland, you hate fishing.
That ain't totally true.
And how many days you gone fishing?
What? I go fishing all the time. Caught you, didn't I?
I am a catch.
Don't I know it.
I got you a present.
Oh, you shouldn't have. What'd you find?
I'll tell you later. I don't mean to interrupt your chat with your, girlfriend, but, we gotta get moving.
What the hell was that?
So, where'd you get the bag, Dee? Dee? Dee, did you hear me?
What's in the bag, Dee?
I told you, it's a surprise.
She looks like she needs to speak to someone's manager.
Dee, when we get back to camp, would you let me borrow some of that nail polish?
Sure, hon. You like this color?
It's my favorite. And after today, I could use a new coat, you know?
Same here. I feel like a drowned rat with these claws.
Not to interrupt the girl talk here, but, Dee, that bag...
Look, I found it down the road a piece, all right?
Where down the road?
Some place off that-a-way.
Damn it, Dee, you gotta give us more than that.
Was anyone there?
I don't think so.
You don't think, or you don't know?
Those mean the same thing, Leland.
Just tell us, baby.
You guys sure gang up on me a lot lately.
Honey, that ain't true.
Tell me one time you sided with me in the last week. The last month.
All right. I can't remember one especially, but I know I have.
False. This is how all our fights go, every time. Now we're standing here in the woods, soaking through, and for what? Don't you want to get to the camp before dark?
I ain't
Hush,
the one
your
who
voice
stopped.
Is down. Come on
But
now.
You are the one who made me stop.
Irregardless, we could just as easy carry on like this while we're walking.
That. Oh, I've about had it with that attitude.
Attitude?
You're going to draw every dead thing from miles around you keep on like
this. In
this
goddamn middle
I know
of nowhere
you did
place.
That on purpose.
You listen to me now. I have had it up
I
to here with listening
not
to you.
To blaspheme.
I can't believe you are still religious after
My
what we've been
ain't
through.
Something I wear like a fucking sweater.
These two are fun.
Don't just take it off. When it gets uncomfortable. Bonnie, darling, I'm sorry we're...
Darling?
Dee, come on.
Save it. I know what side your bread is buttered on. Yours, too.
Dee, now's not the time. Whatever issues we got, we'll hash them out later.
I refuse to get in the middle of this.
Well, too bad. You already are.
Drama.
I'm sorry. I just want to get somewhere where I can change my clothes, and then you and your girlfriend can... Oh, shit. Oh, no. Oh, God, run. Come on, we gotta move.
What are you talking about?
Oh, shit.
Oh, hey, it's the people she stole from.
Wait up, yo!
Oh,
oh
damn. And I'm dead. Well, maybe not, but still. Oh, look, it's Officer Useless again. That was easy. Damn, this is pretty intense. More than I remember, actually.
Hey, Leyland!
Through here! Look!
God damn it.
Dee!
That didn't sound good.
I think I see him! Over here!
Come on, Bonnie. Come on.
Jeez.
Shit. Where are you?
Jeff, you see something?
Where the hell?
Make note of the names they call out, by the way. They dispersed through this cornfield pretty quickly.
Anything?
No! I can't see a damn thing out here!
I feel like I should make a Children of the Corn joke, but it might be a bit of a reach.
Mama, watch over me. Okay, Bonnie. Stay calm. Find a weapon.
Die, Fee.
Bonnie.
Oh, shit. Oh, that is so bad.
So sorry. Oh, God.
That is messed up.
Why? You. Why?
It was dark. It's so dark. I couldn't see you. I didn't know it was you. How was I supposed to know it was you?
There was no. I thought I saw you. You did this. God, you killed me. You killed me.
Anybody see anything?
I should never.
That's making me nauseous, actually. Holy crap.
You. Just a junkie. Leland. She to me.
God, I'm so sorry. I can't. Oh, God.
I knew you'd fuck up again. Take him.
No, God, I'm sorry. I need him. I need you both.
You bitch. Mary, you wanted him. Didn't. Thank you. Had the stones.
Dee, I would never. I swear this has nothing to do with him. It was an accident.
You fucking junkie.
Spread out. It can't be far.
Sheesh.
Dee, did you find her? Honey, I thought they got you back there. Jesus, are you shot? Dee. God, what happened? Oh, Jesus. Oh, Lord, Bonnie, what happened? Oh, my God, Dee. Marlon, what happened to you? Your face. Her face, Bonnie.
I had to. I thought you would...
What do you mean, Bonnie? What was that you just said?
It really was an accident, Leland. It really...
You did this? You did this to my Dee?
She came out of nowhere. I thought she was one of them. I didn't see her until she was right there.
I don't believe this. I don't understand. How did it happen?
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, Leland.
Bonnie.
Back this way!
Oh, I
no,
feel sick.
Which way?
There!
I'm sorry to do this to you, darling. Leave you here.
Call out if you see
this
him.
Way.
I know it's hard, but I need you,
Leland.
I
wouldn't have felt right lying here, even. I don't know. It's a tough call, as usual.
I think I saw something over here.
They went this way!
What the hell are you doing?
If she's gonna die for this thing, I for damn sure ain't leaving it behind.
You got a point. Man, what a clusterfuck. And so now for Shell's story, the final one. Like I said, there's all kinds of little details and Easter eggs scattered throughout the whole thing here. In Vince's story, when the zombies first start attacking, you could see an older woman and a young girl running away, and that's actually two of the characters from here. This gas station seems like a popular place. Thank you, Kurt Cobain.
Hey, Shell. Your sister's getting pretty good, huh?
Becca had a good teacher, Steph. Thank you for doing that. She needs something to focus on besides, you know, everything else.
Yeah. Growing up in a world like this...
You might recognize Steph there from the cornfield.
What do you think that does to a kid?
I don't know. I know it's changed me. Well... all of us, but at this age, for her, I don't know.
Becca's a good kid. These are shit times, and she's gonna go through that. But if we can keep her from experiencing some of the shit I've seen...
Thanks, Stephanie.
So Steph's pretty attractive for a, you know, pixelated character.
Thanks.
Just saying.
Becca, that was great.
Thanks, sis. You think we can do something like this every week?
That sounds like a great idea. Maybe we can all get in on it, like some kind of weekly talent show.
That was amazing, Becca. We could all use a little more music in our lives. Did I ever tell you that I used to play in a band?
Yes, Roman, you've told us. She doesn't want to hear about it again.
All right, all right. In that case, let's get back to work. Oh, and thanks to Boyd's hard work on the vegetable garden, we're having fresh soup tonight. Okay, let's get to it.
You want to help me and Shell do the supply inspection?
Cool. You check the flashlights this time. I'll look over the guns.
Okay, but be careful. People's lives depend on those. We can't have them screwing up because we got lazy.
Shell, when you get a sec, meet me out back. Help me feed the watchdogs.
Sure thing.
And you guys might recognize some of the older folks among us here from the main game.
How we doing on ammo?
Better than we thought. We haven't had to use these for a while.
What did Roman want?
I don't know yet.
Are you gonna find out?
Yeah, in a sec.
God, can I get some time to myself? What the hell?
Huh. Still one short. We never found the other flashlight?
Nope. Still in the cornfield somewhere, I guess.
You guys need help?
Nah, we got this. Right, Becca? You go ahead and help Roman out back.
So yeah, it should be clear by now, but these are the people you were just running from in the cornfield.
Looks weird in here without the paintings.
Well, Boyd wanted something to paint his own pictures on. I guess it'll be a personal gallery in here when he's done.
Let me through, Dan. Oh, there we go. And there's the guy.
He's hungry. Guess he knows it's feeding time.
It's disgusting.
Can't disagree with you there. You know, your sister said she wouldn't mind doing this.
Roman, we've talked about this. Becca doesn't need to deal with this kind of thing.
Listen, I know you think that giving her an easy life is what's best, but it's really not.
This is far from an easy life, Roman.
You know what I mean. She needs to know the sacrifices we have to make to survive in this world.
As long as she knows how to protect herself, it's fine. I don't want her to stop caring about people.
Okay. What's that one eating?
I don't know. I'll check it out.
I gotta get back out front. Looking forward to that soup.
I gotta say, this series doesn't have a really great track record in terms of people keeping walkers on chains. It's usually a big red flag.
Oh, God.
Well, that's depressing. And it's the old lady from the diner. Eating a puppy, because they just gotta kick you right in the nuts like that. That's messed up. Yeah, animals tend not to do very well in this series. Just ask Rick Grimes.
Oh, Jesus, don't ever fucking do that again!
Whoa, what's your problem? I do this all the time. You don't get all pissed off.
I'm sorry, it's just the watchdogs. I guess they found a puppy.
A puppy?
Yeah. I guess it just got to me. You know, it was so little. You don't think about babies anymore, but after a while you just kind of accept this is it.
Yeah. I guess you kind of forget.
That would bum me out too, to be honest.
But then, you know, there it is. You see it, and you want to protect it, and now it's gone.
That sucks. Maybe if Clive dies next, we can put him out there instead. He'd make a better watchdog anyway.
What the hell, kid?
Becca.
Shell! Becca! Something's going on outside!
What is it?
I don't know. Something bad. We gotta find Roman.
Is it more puppies? Please, no.
Come here, everyone.
Shit. Come on, we gotta find Roman.
This month, it was so care to be there.
Jesus.
Largum.
My God. Largum. What did you do?
All I did was put on the blindfold and bind his wrists. Somebody else beat him up. He already had the cuts and bruises.
Watchdogs caught him trying to steal supplies.
Sure he did.
Is he bitten?
No, they didn't get that close.
Who is he?
I got no idea. I don't think he speaks English.
I can't believe he just snuck
in.
It's
the second break-in we've had in the last couple of weeks. Last time we couldn't catch him. They got away with more medicine than we could afford to lose.
Well, we all know what it's like trying to survive out there. He just came in here for food. Let's just give him some and send him on his way.
But what if there are more of them? He could have been scouting.
That's right. He could be part of a larger group.
If there were more, I think we would have seen them by now. I mean, nobody travels alone by choice anymore, right?
Boyd's right. We should just let him go.
Why?
Look at the poor bastard. We've all done the same thing trying to survive. We don't have to be responsible for him, but we can give him some food and let him take his own chances.
It's not about his chances. It's about ours. What's to stop him from coming back? And armed next time?
We could always use more hands keeping the place secure.
Boyd, we don't need any more people here. And look at him. How is he gonna...
He can't even speak English. This group works because we know
Thanks,
how to
Donald
communicate.
Trump.
Are you judging him based on race?
Of course not. But come on.
Well, he's not staying here. You let in a stranger,
well,
and everything starts breaking down.
The last time we did that, we lost Bree. And then Vernon with that goddamn boat.
Vernon Uh-oh. And the boat are the reason the group fell apart. Not trusting strangers. Vernon was out for the boat the whole time. And the second they left that boat unattended, we just stole it. That's when our group fell apart.
He can't stay here.
I agree. Keeping him here is not an option. In his condition, he'd be a drain on our resources. Look, we all know what we're talking about here, so let's stop dancing around it. We either let this guy go and take our chances, or we kill him.
Jesus Christ, are you serious?
Roman's right. It's gotta be one or the other.
We're letting him go. It's the only right thing to do.
I'm telling you, we can't do that.
But killing him? Is that really the answer?
I mean, what choice would you
Stephanie,
guys make here? Holy
Boyd,
crap.
You two don't think we should kill him. We know where Joyce and Clive stand on the subject. You're the swing vote here, Shell. What's it gonna be?
Damn it. My sister's already too bloodthirsty.
We have to set him free.
We can't just shoot a guy in front of her. Come on.
We can't. He's not even armed. We can't just kill him. This isn't in self-defense.
Isn't it, though? If it means he can't come back to hurt us?
That isn't the same thing.
But last time...
Joyce, that was a long time ago. If we kill this man, then we're giving up a part of ourselves that we can never get back. I'm not ready to let that go.
I think he's speaking Portuguese, by the way.
Cut him free.
I hope you guys know what you're doing.
Oh,
give him some food, three or four cans, just as a gesture of good faith. And get him out of here. I don't know if you can understand a word I'm saying, but you better understand this. You came this close to death today. And if you ever, ever come near this place again, or tell anybody where we are, you wish you had died today.
Let's be honest, that's probably gonna... That's a decision that's gonna bite us in the ass, you just know it.
Do you have any fours?
Nope. Do you have any sevens?
Yep.
I miss playing guitar for everyone. It was stupid, but fun. Why don't we do that anymore?
Since the attack, there's a lot we don't do anymore.
Yep.
I shouldn't have let that guy go. Boyd would still be alive and everything would be the same.
Boyd agreed it was the right thing to do. Anyway, Roman's obsessed with keeping this place secured now.
You know that's impossible, right?
Well, after last time, Roman isn't taking any chances.
And I should fix the loose board behind the storage lots.
Becca, are you sneaking out again?
Damn it, Carl, stay in the house.
Oh, God, do you know how dangerous that is?
It's not dangerous. There's nothing out there but slow-ass walkers.
What are you talking about? We've had two break-ins already.
So she's
anyone
basically
could
the
be out there. What if someone sees you and follows you back here?
They won't.
Damn it, Becca.
Shell, I need to talk to you.
It's open. What's going on?
Hey, Becca.
Hey.
When you get a sec, I need you to come out and talk to me. It's important.
Okay.
I'll be outside. You'll see me.
Give us a minute.
Yeah. Just don't take too long.
What was that all about?
I don't know. Probably not good, though. Stay here. It'll be just a minute. I'll fill you in when I get back.
I love how, like, the whole mood has just completely turned dark. Fine, I won't look at the planter then. Sheesh. There's a painting Boyd will never finish now.
Joyce, do you know what's going on?
I don't know if I should say anything.
Please, what is it?
They caught Stephanie stealing and then trying to escape.
Oh my God. What are they gonna do?
I don't know. What can we do?
I'll go talk to Roman. We'll figure it out.
You know, debating whether you're gonna kill someone when, you know, to protect yourselves when it's a stranger is one thing, but what do you do when it's your best friend?
Roman?
Good, you're here.
I heard about Stephanie.
I'm sorry.
What are you gonna do?
You know what we do.
What happened?
We caught her trying to escape.
Well, so what, Roman? Ever since the incident, this hasn't been an easy place to live in. If she doesn't want to stay, let her take her chances out there.
Well, A, she had most of our seeds, medicine, and ammo with her. And B, you know we can't let anyone leave who knows where we are. She screwed us, Shell. All of us. And now we're in that position again where we can't keep her here and we can't let her go. You do know why I'm telling you this, right?
Yeah. You want me to take care of it.
You and Boyd were the ones who fought to let that guy go. Convinced us all to take that chance. But we did. And it was wrong. And now Boyd is dead. We're beyond the luxury of taking chances now. And I need to know that you're with us 100%.
But she's one of us. This is different.
No, she's not. Not anymore. She tried to sneak out and leave us without any medicine or extra ammo. She knew. That could mean the death of any one of us. You got your gun?
It's in the camper.
I'll give you a few minutes to get your head together.
God, what do I tell Becca?
That's up to you. Whatever you say, I'll back you up.
I mean, if you're gonna make me shoot my best friend, that's the point where I'm just gonna burn everything to the ground, honestly.
Shell? What's wrong? Am I in trouble?
It's Stephanie. She stole a bunch of supplies and tried to escape.
Oh my god. What the hell did she do that for?
Roman says we have to...
Kill her? Yeah. Why would she do this to us?
What the hell, kid?
She's just scared. She made a mistake.
That'll be our last mistake.
Becca, Stephanie is your friend.
Was my friend.
Roman wants me to do it.
I'm sorry. Let's just get it over with. Your gun's over there, in the drawer.
Bloodthirsty little shit. Decision time.
You know, we don't have to do this. We can just go.
What?
We've survived on our own before. If we just go, we can be out of here before anyone can do anything about it.
Are you crazy? Where would we go? There's nothing out there. As long as we're here, we're safe. The group will protect us.
But for how long?
I don't know. Longer than we'd survive out there. Besides, you know the rules. If we try to leave, Roman will hunt us down. We don't have a choice. This is who we are now.
I don't want this to be who we are.
Just let me do it then.
Fucking hell.
Fine. Go ahead.
No! Roman said he wants you to do it. I'll do it when it's my turn. This really sucks.
Not so tough now, are you, you little shit?
Shell, it's time.
Take the gun and shoot Roman in the face. Problem solved. No, but for real, fuck Roman and fuck this place.
What are you doing? Shell? Shell, what the hell?
Sit down, get safe.
Shell, hey!
Shell!
Be safe, I'll stay on it.
No, he won't!
What the fuck? Oh. God damn it!
Epilogue time.
We were right. There are survivors out here.
Still alive? Oh, they're gonna be happy to get rescued. So how many are we talking about?
Around 5, I think. They left a note, so at least we know they want to be found. And I can see smoke in the distance. Probably a camp. I'm gonna try to make contact tonight.
Great. Well, just be careful and use your best judgment. We're building a good community here. We want to keep it that way.
Of course.
So to top things off, it's probably my fault that the gas station got overrun. I did drive right through their front gate, after all.
So good. I'm gonna try to talk to him. Wish me luck.
Yeah, good luck. Be careful. Don't try to force him into anything. Just get as many of them as you can.
I should approach him with like a plate of brownies or something. That fosters some goodwill.
Don't you...
Bits! Don't fucking move! Who the fuck are you?
My name is Tavia.
How did you find us?
I found your note. I'm a scout for a growing settlement up north. We go out and look for survivors to rescue them. We have food, clean water, and shelter for everyone. We're offering you a chance to help us out and start over.
God, this sounds too good to be true, but I think it is.
Bonnie, get real. Just because you have to tell the truth all the time doesn't mean everyone else does.
If I didn't trust people, I'd be dead. I know that for sure. People can care about you if you let them.
Like Leland cared when he let you run off alone.
That's enough, Becca.
I heard rumors about these places.
Becca's a little asshole.
This guy I was traveling with ditched me trying to find one on his own. He thought, you know what? Let's do this. She looks well fed, right? And clean? We could all use a meal and a hot shower.
Hold up. We don't know what kind of people we're dealing with. I don't want to get stuck with some crazy asshole like Russell did.
I walked away from that shit, Wyatt. And that dude was crazy from Jump Street.
Look, we need people. Plain and simple. You folks can decide if you want to come as a group, or split up, or whatever. But I don't want to be out here in the open after dark. So in a few minutes, I'm going to be getting back in my car and on my way. Hopefully, at least some of you will follow me.
Well, I'm going.
Maybe we should go too, sis. If Roman is still looking for us, he wouldn't be able to do anything to us there.
There's no way that guy is still looking for you. We've been to that truck stop. There's no one left.
Roman's not a problem. It's following her that'll get you killed.
Look, I know it's a risk, but what else is there? If you guys are going, then so are we.
I don't like this, guys. We should just walk away. I don't trust her.
Of course you don't, Russell. You don't trust anyone.
Can you blame him? So yeah, as usual, it's determinant.
What will it take to
convince
you? The
choices you make with each character decides whether they'll go or not at the end here.
Come on.
Guys, trust me. We need to get to this place.
Well, it could be a trap. What if they want to kill us?
Thank you. Everyone out there is batshit crazy. We've all seen it.
Well, we turned out all right, didn't we?
You clearly outnumber me. If you wanted to overpower me, you could. Hell, I'll even go along as your hostage until you feel safe. No one is gonna hurt you.
That's not a bad idea, actually.
And I'll do it. Because I know when you guys see this place, you'll change your minds. Look, I know you guys are wary, and you have every right to be. You don't know me from a hole in the ground. And yeah, there are some crazy fuckers out there. All I'm here to do is make an offer. You can come with me, or you can stay here. The choice is yours.
And these guys haven't even seen the cannibals yet.
Who wants to come with me?
Yeah, I'm going.
I'm just not sure. We've been out here for so long and seen so much bullshit. I mean, is it really worth getting our hopes up?
Of course it is, Russell. Hope is all we've got left.
But being smart, that's what's keeping us alive.
It's a safe place for everyone. Criminal activity isn't tolerated within our walls, period. You don't have to worry about bandits or walkers or anyone else. We look out for each other. Is that clear?
Yeah, clear.
I don't know. I don't really believe in safe places. Not anymore.
I know it's hard, but this is your only chance. We're not going to be out this way again for a long time.
We understand. I think we've all made up our minds.
Well, I guess we have our group. What do you want to do with these?
Note that Wyatt is wearing a hat in that picture, whereas on the board he wasn't, so that's kind of an error.
This is a good thing. I know it is.
How do we know this will work out?
What's the alternative? Staying out here?
All right, roundup time. Seriously, people... 70% of people sided with the freaking child rapist dude. I mean, come on. Like, yeah, Justin wasn't particularly trustworthy, but I mean, at least, you know, he wasn't a rapist. Come on. And I guess it's... I think with Wyatt and Eddie, the game actually kind of pulls an RNG on you with that. And I'm getting a network notice again. That's just great. Where, like, the game kind of it doesn't really matter when you're playing rock, paper, scissors what you pick. I think that the game kind of decides ahead of time if you're going to be getting out of the car or not, because this is the first time I played that Wyatt actually got out of the car. 75% of players left Nate because he's a crazy sumbitch. Only 25% of players were honest with Leland. Well, you did cave in his wife's skull, so that's understandable. And of course, 75% of people chose not to execute Steph, their best friend, because that's just messed up. So I was going to say that, you know, this episode is a little bit shorter than the other episodes, but it's not really. It seems about the same. The choices and everything that happens here, the characters involved, it all leads into Season 2, and I should be starting that on Saturday. I mean, unless my ISP decides to really screw with me. Oh, damn. Usually I get everybody but Russell to go with me. That I think Bonnie goes no matter what, and Russell, you have to really make just the right choices for him to go with you. And then Wyatt staying, that's never happened before. Every time I've played this, everybody but Russell comes with leaves Latavia, so that's kind of a weird change. And here you get to see some stills of the results of your choices. Is it bad that I've forgotten her name already? shit, poor angry middle-aged housewife lady. So in trying to avoid killing Stephanie, we may have killed everybody, literally everybody else at the camp. I mean, in the case of Roman, you know, screw Roman, but everyone else I feel kind of bad about. I kind of wonder if Nate, well, I did wonder if Nate was ever going to come back at some point. There's Danny. Because Nate just kind of came in, screwed shit up, and then you just never really hear from him again, I don't think. There's Nate finding the officer we ran over, I guess. Alright, that's it for The Walking Dead Season 1. I'll be starting Season 2 on Saturday, and, you know, hopefully everything works out ISP-wise, and I'll see you guys there.